Ex-Canadian superstar Kurt Browning, who earlier this week went with Paul Wiley out to a Japanese restaurant for a nice, quiet dinner.
Potatoes. Okay. Just a little bit.
Paul thinks he's playing it safe by ordering potatoes. Little did he know.
Hey,
it's our order.
Every time I say something, he writes it down.
I know, it's a little
scary.
We're
going to get like the whole menu. My nerves are shattered.
To calm his nerves, Browning orders some traditional sake. He thinks.
They're talking about me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
Oh, here comes the crowd. Thank you.
You're sure that those are crabs, not spiders?
And finally, the ultimate test for these two champions.
This is the challenge of champions right here.
Just clip like everything
and just keep chewing.
Not that. Oops, sorry, ma'am.
This is serious business.
I'm laughing at this.
One, two, three. Oh my god.
Oh, he crunched that.
Open wide.
I don't think so, Paul. Next to skate Canadian Kurt Browning, who turned professional earlier this season, and it has been a trying year.
First year as a pro has lived up to the expectation of being difficult. And as an amateur, I think that there are different demands. And now that I'm professional, being able to perform in all sorts of different situations has certainly been one of them. The level of competition has been, for me, higher as a professional. I think I expect more from myself, and I have actually achieved less than I wanted.
And here is the four-time world champion, 28-year-old Canadian Kurt Browning, who needs a near-perfect performance to overtake Viktor Petrenko.
And this is going to be an interesting contrast. We had two serious numbers, one from Paul Wiley and one from Viktor Petrenko. And now we see Kurt Browning take the ice with a rather humorous program, one with a lot of fun, and opening up with the triple axel. Oh, a little shaky on that landing. Given that he's had trouble with that jump all season, he shouldn't be too disappointed with that one. Triple loop. Oh, that was beautiful.
Lisa, you mentioned the program is dancing to Bluesberry Hill by the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band. And one of the things he wanted to do was to get the crowd into it right away, and he's done that. Browning, a four-time world champion, but the one thing that's missing from his mantle, an Olympic medal. Back injury in 1992, he finished a disappointing sixth and a very disappointing fifth in the 94 Olympics.
The triple sow cow. Very well done, and that's what he's got to do if he's going to be a contender in this competition.
And he looks very loose. Talking to him earlier in the week, he was very happy that this is the last event of his first professional season, and very much looking ahead to next year.
Oh no! Well, he's going to make something here for something. You gotta give him credit for that.
Bird having a lot of fun drilling the crowd with his footwork.
You know, he looks like he's a little tired. His stroking is a little strained. Nice double axel, but almost loses his balance right there.
Kurt Browning with a lighthearted program, complete with a fall that may have endeared him even more to these Japanese fans.
It may very well have done that, Terry, but unfortunately it might have also taken him out of the running. There were a number of imperfections in that program that could have hurt his chances for a number one placement.
He may not win, but he's won a few hearts here in Tokyo today. We'll take a look at Kurt Browning's scores when we return. Back to Tokyo as an out of breath Kurt Browning settles in, flowers in hand after an exhaustive program. He takes a nasty spill, but he makes a valiant comeback, losing his footing right about here and then making the most of it.
He does indeed, and you know, you have to give him credit as a true pro. He gets up and carries on and converts it into a humorous event.
Making the most of a bad situation, and Kurt Browning receiving his technical merit marks pretty good. 9-8s and 9-9.
Not bad, but certainly not enough to overtake Petrenko and Wiley.
And for artistic impression, look at these. 9-8, 9-9s, and even 2-10s.
Well, it was a lively performance and a humorous one, but I don't think it deserved 2-10s.
And his total of 98.7 currently places Kurt Browning in third behind Victor Petrenko and Paul Wiley.